It's been a while, hasn't it? Welcome to another dramatic fanfiction readings. Tonight, on the slicing board, is a fanfiction by Mr. Market. It's a Super Mario fanfiction called Bowser's Mexico Adventure. Let us read. It was a dark, foreboding early afternoon in 8-4, much like any other. Wet Bowser had just finished his morning ritual of mowing his lava and was about to embark on his daily constitutional when he caught a glimpse of something poking out of his mailbox. A brief flicker of excitement danced across his turtle face as he realized it was an envelope. Wet Bowser embossed in fancy gold cursive lettering on the front. He hastily tore open the letter with one claw and began to read. Dear Wet Bowser, we are pleased to inform you that you are cordially invited to attend the grande opening of Phase 3 of our new... I'm just gonna say Lady, because that's funnier. Resort faculties in sunny Delfino Island just off the coast of Costa Rica in Mexico. You will enjoy 8 days and 7 nights free of charge after participating in a brief tour of the resort, during which you will be offered an opportunity to buy into and become a VIP member of our exclusive program. We welcome you to invite friends and family, and free will be available to you if you sign up. If they sign up as well. We look forward to seeing you. Greg, for Presidente of the Mexico. Yes, the Mexico. I'm taken aback, Wet Bowser exclaimed. Taken aback. He knew just who to invite, and he couldn't wait to deliver the good news as he hurried back to the castle. He picked up the phone and called his old college roommate, Joel, who lived in space. After a few rings, a voice on the other end said, Hello, Mr. Market's Steak and Lube, how can we review today? Yeah, give me an order of steak and 20 ounces diet lube. Hey, wait a minute, Crow. Crow T Robot, is that you? Put Joel on the phone. I need to speak to an adult. But Uncle Bowser, Crow whined. Bowser was about to grumble a response when he heard a friendly, familiar voice on the line. Joel, colon. Hello, who am I speaking with? Bowser, colon. Hey, bro, it's Wet Bowser. Joel, colon. Hey, how long's it been, man? Bowser, colon. Too long. What have you been up to? Joel, colon. Oh, you know, watching some movies with the bots and getting ready for our next invention exchange. How about you? Bowser, colon. Well, I was finishing up my gardening today and I got a letter in the mail. I'm going on a free vacation and you're coming along. Bring the bots, too. Joel, colon. Really? Well, that's great. Bowser, colon. Oh, okay, you know what? I'm sick and tired of saying colon. I'm just gonna forget it. Stop by my place around 5. You still remember how to get to my place in Darklands? Joel. Nah, it's okay. I'll just map quest it. Bowser. Sounds terrific. See you then. In another room. Cheatsy. Eavesdropping vacation, huh? This gives me a wild and crafty idea. The next day, Wet Bowser and Joel and the bots went to Mexico. The airport was nice and they got nuts on the plane. Not plane as in airplane, but plane as in a grassy field. P-L-A-I-N. But little did they know of the trouble that was brewing. Mario. Okay guys, make sure you keep your fanny packs in the front this time. Boba Fett. Okay then. This was not my fault. Dr. Forrester. Okay then. Well, at least we made it. That's what really counts. Now where did Joel and the rest of them go off to? I can't believe they left us. Before anyone could reply, Dr. Grant walked up to his colleague and grasped his shoulder reassuringly. Grant. With a capital ending T. But that's not... What I'm gonna do! Mario. Well, the guy at the airport said the resort is just past these mangroves. Eerie noises came out of the mangroves. Ooh. Scary. Mazenrath. Who is that? Boba Fett. Let's keep moving before something bad happens. Elsewhere, Wet Bowser and the gang were just getting into their suite. You spelled sweet wrong. You spelled it S-W-E-E-T. So, wait, what? Not like a hotel suite, but... forget it. Anyway, when they began to quarrel over who got to sleep in what room with who, Tom said, well, Joel! Crow's not letting me have the sink! You got the window seat on the way down, so I get to sleep in the sink. Crow. I needed the window because of my heart condition. We've been over this. Joel. Now, guys, you can both have the sink. Look, there's two sinks. Wet Bowser went into his room and opens his suitcase, only instead of his clothes tumbling out, seven Koopa kids tumble out. At first he was confused, and then he raged. What is this? He raged. Ludwig, we came along too. You'd never take us on vacation after that trip to Colonia Williamsburg, King Dad. Wet Bowser, that's because it was horrible. You are a disappointment. I could brain you just about now. Wendy, but Daddy! Bowser, okay, fine, you can come along, but you have to come to the Orendadian Zoo. Seven Koopa kids. Okay. Elsewhere in the mangroves. Dry Bowser, king of the mangrove. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Everything is going according to my plan. Thuggo, yes, your evil dryness. After unpacking, they thought they should go to see the beach because it was right there, even though it was really hot outside. When they got outside, there was a fat man sitting at a table under an umbrella, and he looked to be on vacation by his Hawaiian shirt and other clothes. Nedry, don't get cheap on me, Bowser. This was Hammond's mistake. What, Bowser? Begrudgingly, ugh, fine. Pays for his meal. And suddenly, Richie Rent ran by, his arms outstretched, straight into the ocean. Richie Rent. Wanshi! Everyone. Yeah, I'll run into the ocean. This is fun. I could do this all day. They were all having fun when, inside Joral's head, mangroves. Kill your friends and dump them into me. Crow. Joel, are you okay? Joel. Yeah, I'm fine, bro. I guess I'm just not used to the heat out here. Crow. Okay, if you say so. The next day, everyone went to the Orentian. It lasted over